Wow, you're telling me about this. I'll tell you about that. Stop talking shit, you walk into another trap. When all the time you know my name. You know my name, you know my name. Just settle down, you're losing the blood. It took you a lifetime to get where you got. If I had it all, I'd be dead in a week. If I had my way, be king for a day.
Who are we? Well, my name is Thomas Peter Meehan, and this guy's called Sergio Lorenzo Pisano, and we're in a band called Kasabian.
Why should people care about Kasabian?
Lock your daughters up.
We come from the Midlands, mate, right? Leicester. And next door, Black Sabbath, Led Zeppelin, Slade, Hawkwind.
All from the same area.
Yeah, you forget that motherfucker, don't you?
There's a great age in this, you know, 60s, 70s, and even 80s and 90s period, you know, and we're even in the, like, you know, the noughties or whatever they call that fucking stupid name. I think there's no such thing anymore, do you know what I mean? I don't think you'd have that kind of golden age where you get a crop of rock stars, you know, like, you know, David Bowie's or anyone in that category, or fucking what they called, Tell Me When Will I See Her Again, Human League, even they were fucking rock stars, and look at them, do you know what I mean? It's just all social network now, and you know, and it's all changed, you know.
'04 was unbelievable, because that's when we first come out and the first album was out, and we just played and played and played until, you know, fucking my throat was bleeding and Sergio's fingers bled, you know. We could stay up all night, all the time, and then do a gig, and then do it again, and do it again.
What the fuck?
We had more energy then, you know, we haven't lost it, but we were only young, we were 23 years old, you know, I'm 33 nearly next week, so, you know, 10 years, yeah, I mean, we could just do it, you know, we could do it then, but we only have about seven songs in the set. Started upsetting a lot of journalists by saying we're the best band in the fucking world, you know, so, and they probably still are upset, because we're still here, you know, which I love more than anything.
What I'm seeing with a lot of, you know, bands, young bands, they are considered, they wouldn't say shit like that because they know it might offend a few people or it might not kind of read great. Because we didn't care. I mean, we did all those interviews, like, smashed. I mean, that, you know, off our heads, you know. But it kind of, and it does wind people off. But that's a good thing.
We just make music and we see what happens. The only pressure is we put it on ourselves by falling into the trap. We make the same album again and again, and that's not going to happen.
I'm always wanted to sound, and the dream has always been, what would the Stones sound like in 2012? Not let's recreate what the Stones did, let's be influenced and inspired by and bring rock music into the future, I suppose. There's so much going on, you'd be sort of crazy to back yourself into a corner and only do guitars when there's so much incredible music being made. So, you know, we're just a futuristic rock band, that's all we are. I just didn't want, you know, I never wanted for us to be that band that kind of, you know that kind of, you know, fucking boring ass dad rock kind of. No one's got any clue what we're gonna do next.
Have you?
No, absolutely none. And that's
the beauty of it, though, isn't it?
No, surely? It is, exactly. Yeah, yeah. And I've always, it keeps me on my toes, and it keeps everyone else on their toes. And if you can't split the audience, and if you ain't got the balls to split the audience on your first single, then you should go and be an accountant, you know.
You set yourself a limit or a bar to hit, you know, or a goal. You know, I'd like to be number one again in England. I'd like to be number one in America. That's really difficult unless you're Adele. In my element, yeah, on that stage, I feel like a Jedi Knight. Yeah, so that's how I feel. It's just something just there, you know. That's where I'm in my element, making people happy, I suppose, making people forget things, making people have a great night. Rock and roll's about losing yourself, isn't it? In the music, and people do all sorts of crazy things, and it sends people crazy, and it makes people cry, makes people passionate. People get married to it. People have babies to it. Do you know what I mean? It's the whole life thing.